Our next speaker, as you know, truly needs no introduction. So I could just end there, but I've got to mention a few things about him, because he's such a, become such a dear friend. He's like a brother to me. Brother somewhere along the line, for sure. He came to England first in 1986 and spoke at a society conference, Society of Veritas conference. And we were amazed. Yes, we were amazed. The world has given us Raj and Sankara. Thank you.
First of all, it's such a fun, a joy to be with all of you, and especially all my dear friends here whom I know for so many years. And when we meet, it's like a family reunion. And we crack the silliest of jokes and have fun. It's a great pleasure. About the conference, also I'm very happy the way it has worked out. And basically, I think that we saw different approaches and methodologies, different ways of looking at it. And I believe that we can look at it in 7 levels. The first is the name or the diagnosis. So there are many homeopaths who treat the patient on the basis of the diagnosis, pathology. So if you have prostate, you get subulcer ulnar, something like that. In fact, famous homeopaths from the past, like Burnett, used to treat many patients of the same condition with the same remedy. Basilinum for ringworm, or Carduus Marianus for liver complaints. Artica urens for gout, and they reported huge success. Similarly, we have people who treat on the basis of symptoms. Some of the cases of Frederick that he showed yesterday, there were symptoms, characteristic symptoms, repertorization, which we know gives us success too. Then we have the emotions. Many homeopaths have understood remedies in emotional terms. Pulsatilized, mild, yielding, weeping, desire for consolation, netramoris, disappointed in love, so forth. And this kind of homeopathy works too. We know it very well. Then came the idea of delusion. How does someone perceive reality? What are the dreams that he gets? How does he look at it? And also in this comes the idea of themes. What are the things happening in his life? How does he relate to his parents? How does he relate with his spouse? Is this a perception of abuse? Is this a perception of victimization? What is it like? This is also very, very useful. Another level that we can prescribe on is the sensation. Sensation is the experience of the person. How does he experience it? For example, says, I feel you know, dominated by somebody. I feel as if somebody is crushing me under their foot. And how does this feel, this crushing, because that's still a delusion. How does it feel? How does it be experienced? It says, I feel right. That's what I experience. And that often is a very, very deep experience. It doesn't come out so easily in a case taking. There is a whole technique, a methodology by which you can get there. It's a very difficult step for the patient to take. But when you get there, then the patient starts speaking a language which is not human. It has nothing to do with his mind at all, nothing to do with situations. It has to do with a deep inner experience which actually correlates to something in nature, an animal, mineral or plant. So you can prescribe at that level too. Or you can prescribe on the energy pattern that is shown by the hand gestures or by the sound. The whole sound, the whole pattern. So which is the best level to prescribe on? Can you have a guess? The level of the patient, exactly.
El método UMA, una aproximación matemática a la homeopatía.
I'm going to introduce you the HUMA, the HUMA method.
La homeopatía sigue fielmente el método científico.
Homeopathy follows a strictly scientific method.
Y ha utilizado, descubierto por Hahnemann, la clave de los síntomas.
And it really focuses on the keys of the symptoms.
Que aparecen en los proving y aparecen en los pacientes. Y esta relación a través de los síntomas es el modelo que todos nosotros tenemos de la homeopatía. Hace muchos años con el doctor Carrara sistematizamos el modelo clásico y lo llamamos homeopatía pura.
So, with his they actually systemized and synthesized his classical method.
Basados en la doctrina hahnemanniana, las investigaciones de Bonninghausen y nuestra propia experiencia, establecimos 8 pasos del método puro de la homeopatía.
So based on the Hahnemannian doctrine, and Bonninghausen's research and their own experience, they established 8 main steps of pure method of homeopathy.
En el segundo paso, al trazar el cuadro de la enfermedad dinámica, decíamos de no dejar por fuera ningún síntoma que tuviese el paciente.
And they advised in the second step to draw a picture of the dynamic disease without leaving aside any data of the patient, and from this data, in the third step, to only analyze 2 of the 5 symptoms.
Y de estos datos, en el tercer paso, debíamos analizar 2 a 5 síntomas, los más modalizados, los que habían estado presentes históricamente en el paciente como la llave, como el código para encontrar la sustancia que cubre la totalidad del del caso a tratar.
And the most modified, and those who have been present historically in the patient, is the key to find the substance that covers the whole of the case to be treated. And we had a great success.
Y tuvimos éxito con Hugo Carrara. Nuestro libro se tradujo a 5 idiomas y esta metodología no fue muy eficaz.
And success was visible as our book was translated into 4 languages.
El código de los síntomas era,
so the code of the symptoms,
el modo de relacionar la materia médica con nuestros pacientes.
So it was really the way to connect the patient with material medica.
Ahora, 2 dificultades para establecer este código. La probable número de sustancias y el probable número de sustancias en los rubros sintomáticos. Primera pregunta, ¿cuántas sustancias hay en la naturaleza? Dado que cualquier sustancia puede provocar una patogenesia. ¿Se han preguntado esto? David Hogsworth, profesor de biociencia de la Universidad de Complutense de Madrid, dice que hay aproximadamente 1,5 millones de hongos. 1,5 millones de hongos. ¿Cuántos remedios tenemos? ¿Cuántos hongos tenemos? Aproximadamente 35. Terry Erwin, etnologista del Instituto Nacional de Historia de Washington, dice que 30 millones de sustancias él cree que hay, 50.000 especies de animales tropicales, 950.000 insectos clasificados de los supuestamente 7 u 8 millones de insectos que debe haber. ¿Cuántos tenemos nosotros en la patogenesia, nuestra patogenesia? 30 remedios. Arthur Chapman, dice, especialista en biodiversidad australiana, dice que él cree que entre 15 o 50 millones de especies son los que habitan el planeta. Pero no todos están de acuerdo con esto.
No everyone agrees with this.
Quiere decir que nuestros provins de ser 2.500, 2.800, significan el 0.01666 de la materia médica. El similimum ideal del paciente de todas estas sustancias debe estar en este grupo. El 99,84% de los casos. Como dice Jeremy, lo más seguro que los remedios que nosotros llamamos el similimum sea solo el mejor similar de este grupo. Por ejemplo, 38.000 especies descritas de arañas y probables, dicen, 200.000. Los provins nuestros, 20. Serpientes, 3.000, 20.000 probables especies. Provins, 24 aproximadamente. Moluscos, 200.000, 1,5 millones de especies probables. Provins, 10. De los pájaros, 15.000, la especie probable no se sabe. Provins.
Hello, you are causing depression.
Thank you. Yeah. Yeah. But escuchen esto, según Yari Lennon, que no es John Lennon, de la Universidad de Indiana, dice que bacterias, debe haber cerca de 1 trillón de especies de bacterias. Quiere decir que aún nosotros con nuestra sapiencia podamos decir que este paciente es bacteria. Y digamos, este paciente es una bacteria. Debemos todavía analizar cuál de este trillón de bacterias es el paciente. Es decir, vamos a una segunda cuestión derivada de esa. ¿Cuántos remedios habrá en los próximos años en cada rubro del repertorio? Por ejemplo, el rubro dictador. Ken, del 16, 9 remedios. Bartel, 82, 18. Síntesis del 95-20, Millennium 2004-47, Radar Opus 66. 2050 aproximadamente, 150. Miedo a las tormentas, 11, 12, 25, 38, 57. 2050, 130. Forsaken Feeling, 32, 49, 50, 113, 192, 2050, 400. Aversión a la leche, 30, 60, 62, 78, 130, 2050, 320. ¿Qué quiere decir esto? Cuantos más sustancias experimentadas hay, más remedios habrá. Y cuanto más remedios habrá, más grande es el número de remedios en cada uno de los repertorios. Quiere decir que la individualización por medio exclusivamente del código de los síntomas es un problema. En el futuro, seguro.
That summarizes into what we have to do.